for the safety of the men and women of the Harris County Sheriff's Office. Harris County Sheriff Ed Gonzalez, as of last week, moved to cease all field testing of suspected drugs due to the dangers of possible exposure to fentanyl. Instead, this testing will now be done in a lab-type environment by techs. The safety of our frontline personnel is paramount, so in an effort to protect our frontline personnel, the sheriff has purchased 264 doses of the antidote known as Narcan. Narcan is used to reverse the effects of opioid overdoses, and in addition, deputies are receiving specialized gloves to prevent the synthetic opioids from contacting the skin, as well as masks to avoid the possibility of inhaling the opioids. The distribution of this equipment coincides with training and implementation to ensure deputies avoid exposure to the deadly synthetic opioids that are becoming more and more common on our streets. I'd like to also say that the Harris County Sheriff's Office is very aggressive and proactive with this issue. Our street-level narcotics unit is working on leads every day to try and take down fentanyl houses. We've got, on the federal level, personnel assigned to HIDTA, namely DEA, in an attempt to dismantle and disrupt these organizations in order to keep our community safe. So with that, I'll open it up to any questions.
Chief, is this a preemptive measure, or has there been an instance where there has been exposure by a deputy?
Not by a deputy, but we have had one overdose of opioids that we know of in unincorporated Harris County. And so this is a preemptive measure by the sheriff to ensure that our frontline personnel is not affected in any way. You know, whether it's a street-level type operation or a multi-kilo type operation on the federal level, it's not worth one of our deputies' lives to come in contact with us. So that's why this measure was taken.
Is there a federal assistance in any of the cost of this program?
You know, initially there was, and I believe the city was the one that received some of that. We did not, but like I said, there's not a price tag on the safety of one of our deputies, so the sheriff did take that out of our funds to ensure that our deputies get the equipment that you see in front of us here to ensure their safety.
Can you talk a little bit about how bad the fentanyl epidemic is in this area?
You know, we're seeing it come this way. Like I said, we have had one confirmed overdose regarding fentanyl. We have had some overdoses that have not been confirmed yet, so I don't want to put that out, but confirmed, we do have one confirmed in this area.
Is there specific training that deputies will go through, or how is that going to work?
Yes, sir, and actually they did already. It's a class that was approved by our in-house doctor here. As far as the training, policies have already been implemented, and they have received the training. The Narcan is already out. It's all of our narcotics unit has it. All the FTOs out in the district have it, as well as certain deputies in the area to ensure that it's out there in the event that we need it.
Is the fentanyl issue just getting worse? I mean, is it just starting to really escalate now from what your officers are saying?
It is. Like I said, here in the Houston area, unincorporated Harris County, we've seen just one confirmed overdose, but we know it is something that is heading our way, so we want to be sure that we're ahead of it.
As far as field training, how do the deputies go by handling any kind of narcotics when they're out there? What's the steps that have been taken?
Well, now, with having to make a change, we're making sure that they have the protective gloves that they use, and they're to use them in every scene that they come across, and be sure that they handle it with a lot of caution. Wear the mask in the event that so that they don't inhale the opioid, and you know, it goes in a sealed packet and then transferred over straight to the ME's office.
So they can tell what it is right away?
Yes, sir. It's clearly marked fentanyl, so that when it gets to the lab, they know exactly what it is.
Now, is this in cases where they may suspect there's drugs in the possession of someone's residence or vehicle, but it's not actually I mean, do they have to see some white powder or some pills or something before they gear up, suit up?
Yes, sir. Absolutely. You know, we're relying on their training and experience, and anytime they see that, they'll gear up and protect themselves.
And it's obviously a very small amount.
Just a very minute amount is deadly. It's enough to kill you. Yes, sir.
If they think they see something that is like that, do they typically call in another unit that specializes in this, or do they proceed normally just by gearing up with the protective tire?
Well, both. You know, of course they're going to gear up, but the Harris County District Attorney's Office does rather have the opinion of two deputies, and that's what we're going to require.
What about users? What do they have to look for now? I mean, you know, that's going to happen. They're going to be out. They're going to be out in the field. What can you tell people to look out for, or not to get involved with?
As far as an overdose, or?
Or as far as the narcotic, what does it look like and stuff, and what is it?
Well,
get bit away from.
You know, what we're seeing is it's not just a white powdery substance anymore. They're lacing this stuff with in heroin, marijuana. It's everywhere, so you just never know. You've got to use extreme caution because you never know what's going to be. They're lacing it in everything. They're cutting up kilos of cocaine with it now. So we just have to use extreme caution.
Would this kind of protection, would the public be helped too? Or?
Absolutely. With the Narcan, it's not just for our deputies. It's for the community. If we come across anybody who is overdosed on opioids, we use it on the public as well.
How dangerous is this? I know you probably talked about this.
Right? The Narcan or
not? Not the Narcan, the actual drug.
Fentanyl, just a very minute amount is enough to kill you, so it's very deadly.